Joel, I know you do a lot of work in Texas.
Yes.
Houston, Dallas, Fort Worth, even Austin. What's your take on?
Well, I think in Texas, we have a report coming out from the Center for Opportunity Urbanism about what we call the Texas way of urbanism. And I think if you want to look at where people are moving, where jobs are being created, I think Texas is pretty much in the lead in most of those areas. But what I like most about Texas is, first of all, people are really unpretentious. And what I really like, besides the barbecue and the Tex-Mex, is the fact that they have embraced the idea that you have these two different kinds of markets. If you go to Houston or Dallas, the inner ring is all sorts of exciting things, and that used to be a complete dead zone, and now it's come back. But what's interesting is they continue to build further out, building communities. And one of the things I think that I like most about Texas is that people, young people can go at age 30, 35, buy a house. Minorities, immigrants, they can go buy a house. What disturbs me as a Californian, after even with my New York accent, after 40 years I have a right, is that now it's become so expensive for somebody coming in today that their chances of owning a house, starting a business, moving forward, has begun to diminish. And that's why I think this is this tremendous opportunity for cities like Kansas City to come in and say, we have an alternative. We've got the suburban stuff, we've got the urban stuff, and you know what? You could actually afford it.
I want to